Hello to all. Impossible to talk about Lisbon without mentioning azulejos, simply translated tiles in English. Those everywhere or tiles are inseparable from the Portuguese capital and its magnetic charm. But do you know where they come from? What is the history? Where can you find them? Where to buy them or make them yourselves? Do they only have an aesthetical interest? From the Middle East to the Far East, through Italy, Spain, the Netherlands, before coming back to Portugal, here is the journey of one of the first products of globalization. Complex and fascinating history of azulejos. It is in Baghdad, in the 9th century, that heavenware is discovered. It is the beginning of pottery made out of enameled or vanished clay that gives artists free rein. Glazed clay spread on either sides of Egypt and Persia, then via North Africa to Spain. Glazed clay was then decorated in a geometric and non-figurative manner. Islam is iconoclastic. It forbids icons, idols, and any figurative representation. Those are the azulejos that you will see in Lisbon. That are the azulejos that you will see in Sevilla, for example. From the Moorish and Christian Spain, glazed clay joins Italy in the Renaissance. In Italy, painters decorated the object surface with mythological, allegorical, and biblical scenes. In 1500, it was Italian potters turned to settle in the Netherlands, in Amfert, then Delft, the future capital of the European heavenware. During the same period, the powerful king, Manuel I, discovered the Moorish azulejos in Sevilla and Saragossa. Nothing will be the same ever again. From the 1600s, the Dutch West Indies Company, the first private, modern and international company in the world, established trade relationships with China. Chinese porcelain became a massive hit in Europe. In 1647, supply issues due to political troubles provide Dutch manufacturers with an idea to imitate Chinese porcelain with its white blue patterns. Delft blue was born. Portuguese azulejos were born from those various influences: Arab, Spanish, Italian, Dutch and Chinese. In 1755, heavenware decorated palaces, churches and monasteries. Artists creating drawings with great sense of finesse were called forth. Decorative azulejos were easy to maintain. They were protecting from the damp in winter and the heat in summer. After the 1755 earthquake, tsunami and fire, azulejos were produced in an industrial way, with more basic patterns realized by craftsmen instead of artists. The Marquis of Pombal wanted to cover houses' facades with them, to protect against fire and to improve city engines, inspired by Enlightenment's idea and English rationalism. Where can you see azulejos in Lisbon? Since then, you can find azulejos a bit all over the public and private spaces. Palaces, churches, schools, train stations, blocks of flats, and even more recently, underground stations. The most beautiful collection of azulejos can be found in the Azulejos Museum, in an old and beautiful monastery in the north of Lisbon. The building itself is worth a visit. The museum collection is rich with 7,000 pieces, and it's varied, showcasing the evolution of the art of tiling into earthenware from the Renaissance to today. The 25-meter long fresco representing Lisbon panorama before the 1755 earthquake is mind-blowing. It is made out of none less than 1,300 tiles. You will also find modern works there, sign of the artistic form vitality. São Vicente de Fora Convent in Lisbon is another place to visit if you love azulejos. It hosts 38 panels representing the La Fontaine fables. Cardoes Convent is rather little-known beauty to discover in a district of Barrio Alto. You will learn about a bit of the history of Lisbon, Portugal, and a bit about the history of art of earthenware. The church walls showcase the colorful convent founders' milestones. Where can you buy azulejos in Lisbon? It is possible to buy them in specialized or antiques shops. Shops sell azulejos with modern patterns from the 60s to a day, like Cortizo Inatos. Make your composition on their website, because it is not as easy as it seems to find a perfect composition once you are on site. Azulejo robberies regularly happen in isolated palaces and churches or even in a heart of Lisbon, feeding the black market. Don't buy azulejos in a flea market in Alfama, called the thieves' market for a reason. You can find there the fruit of small theft, the most beautiful pieces finishing in private houses in Spain or in France without ticking the open-air market box. Pieces sold in antique shops are monitored and are not products of theft. You can go there. where can you make azulejos in Lisbon? If you feel creative, you can make your own azulejos at workshops in Lisbon. You can follow Caroline's instructions in French and in English. In 3 hours, you will learn about the history of azulejos, the production principles and the techniques. And then, of course, you will learn to paint using patterns or giving free rein to your exuberant imagination. Or not. It is educational, amusing. It requires diligence and concentration. The most important is that it happens in a friendly and kind atmosphere. Basically, a great moment of learning and play. Once they are fired, you can go home with 2 tiles that you created yourself. Or how to rediscover the joy of being a child, discovering salt dough. Azulejos in Lisbon is a whole story, and we hope that you learn many new things with us. Give us a like if you enjoyed the video or leave a comment. You can also subscribe to our channel. It will motivate us to do even better next time. Be curious and enjoy your stroll.